Oh, somebody's walking here. Are you serious? You're driving in this? We got a water rescue. Just had a water rescue here. Let's see. Oh, they're checking cars.
What's up, YouTube? This is James coming back at you with another informative video. I hope you guys are doing well out there on this hot Monday. I'm doing well myself, and I hope you guys had a very, very nice, relaxing weekend. You know what I always say about that? Went too darn fast, okay? Well, the thing is this though, regardless of this heat, I would rather be dealing with this heat than what Southern Florida is going through right now. Just about a week ago, and they're still under this flood. You understand? I mean, they was hit with this torrential rains that caused, like, you know, this massive flooding and what have you. And it took me back to last year, around May. It's been a year since then, you know, with Ron DeSantis and his antics, you know, being basically hostile towards black people, you know, issuing travel advisories, you know, warnings to Florida. You understand? Basically, they did not care about how they treated black people who came to Florida. And now look at Florida. You know, that's basically what it is. See, I don't know when, you know, the enemy is going to learn. Hey, when you low down and you do these foul things towards the people of the book, there's going to be a price to pay, you know, whether you believe that or not. But that's just what it is. Florida, South Florida, that is underwater. You know, devastation. You understand? As you can see with this car right here, you know, I found this particular picture and there's more like it, you know, bad situation, you know. Without further ado, let's check out this particular news clip and then, you know, we'll finish the commentary.
We've seen so many stolen cars, floodwaters, insurance companies must be ringing off the hook right now.
Local 10's Jeff Wines here is live in Hallandale Beach with that part of our team coverage. Jeff.
State Farm telling us they've already received 625 auto claims. That number has doubled since just yesterday. All the vehicles that you see behind me here were towed in here. Most of them will be totaled. In comes another one. This is a BMW 5 Series. And out back,
got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and some inside the shop.
At the Mercedes Service Center in Hallandale Beach, they are flooded with vehicles.
I got Land Rovers, Porsche Panameras, Mercedes, even brand new Lexuses back there that are flooded and they won't be running anymore.
And it doesn't turn over or anything?
The phone hasn't stopped ringing at Brake Kingdom right next door.
Water in the engine locking up, so waiting for the insurance.
Tell me what it's like right now dealing with the insurance company.
Waiting on it. It's just packed up.
This Saturn Ion was pulled from the parking lot at Gulfstream Park. Sky 10 HD was over that area Thursday morning. It smells.
How high was the water in this car?
Water was that high. There was water in a rear door pocket. A watermark inside the car, right on the gear shift. And inside the engine, the kiss of death. Water inside the air intake.
This is soaked. Once the water gets in the motor, it's going to hydrolock the engine.
Over at Vera Cadillac, Buick, GMC, and Hummer EV in Pembroke Pines, they're assessing the 9 vehicles already towed in. The first is Camaro.
That's water coming from the exhaust. All the water that got sucked in.
10 more vehicles are scheduled to be towed into Vera.
That's water mixed with oil. I'll turn them in that milky white.
Experts say the goal is to keep water away from your air intake and your computer system. Are there certain cars where the intake is lower?
Yeah.
Which ones?
BMWs, Mini Coopers.
If somebody's car stalls out in water, what should they do?
They should leave the car right there. Do not restart it. You restart it, you'll be sucking water into the engine immediately through the air filter and air box.
And there is another one that just came in minutes ago. Many vehicles are still stalled out, abandoned in the roadways in East Hollywood and Hallandale Beach. Insurance companies tell us if you're planning to file a claim, even if your car is still out there, do not wait. Again, State Farm, 625, and that is just one insurance company. We're live in Hallandale Beach. Jeff Wines here, Local 10 News.
Such a tedious process for so many drivers. Thank you, Jeff. And our
Broward County, where many neighborhoods are still full of water.
And Local 10's Andrew Perez is live in Hallandale Beach with a first-hand look at how families are faring there. Andrew.
Yeah, well, families are frustrated, I'll tell you that much. I want you to take a walk with me really quick because we've had scenes like this. This one street's been flooded like this for about 3 days, and some are concerned because of scenes like this. These storm drains are actually pushing water back out. Yet another day of downpours across Broward County. We come across Cecilio Perez, who's literally given up fighting the water, at least for now. There's no solution right now, he says. He takes us into his home in Hollandale Beach to see the water line, to see the mess. He says no one's been by to help or check in.
No ha venido nada, hemos tratado de hablar.
Around his neighborhood, a wet mess. Water still covering roads near Southwest 3rd Street and 9th Avenue. While residents only begin to fix up their cars flooded out by the storms, more rainfall coming down, creating a whole new list of problems.
It's been something I've never experienced in my life before, you know, in the 5 years that I've been here.
Jovan Rodriguez says it got so bad at one point, he and his neighbors helped rescue several people from their flooded out cars, including Lois Bland and her 7-year-old grandson, Malik. She was driving back home.
He's like, Grandma, there's water coming up in the backseat back here. And by that time, the car was stalling out. They grabbed my grandson up, took him over to his house, gave us towels and everything.
Across the county, similar stories. Tow trucks working overtime, dealing with storms throughout the week. From Hollywood slowly drying out to Fort Lauderdale starting to clear out city streets. Residents waiting for these storms to give up so they can clean up. Residents like little Malik say they're lucky, wanting to share this message with a neighbor who stepped up.
Thank you for saving us.
I think he saved me and my grandson's life because nobody else came. Nobody else came.
Well, hopefully once this water goes down, we can set up some kind of a reunion between them and the people who saved them. We've been watching, by the way, just fish, large and small, coming out of this storm drain for the last 30 minutes or so. This is going to be a situation for quite some time right now. Residents are hoping that it goes down, even though we haven't had rain in at least 3 or 4 hours. It's still a problem. The water has nowhere to go. That's the latest here in Hollandale Beach. I'm Andrew Perez, Local 10 News.
Andrew, thanks a lot there.
So as you guys can see, it's a bad situation there in South Florida. You understand, this flooding ain't no joke. Waterlogged cars, waterlogged homes, and storm drains that don't drain properly. You know, that just gives off, far as I'm concerned, a mishandling of tax dollars, you see. Matter of fact, speaking of storm drains, the city where I stay is starting to install new drainage systems, you know what I mean, in, you know, the sewage and all that kind of stuff. Taking all day to get that done too, but nevertheless, you know, it's situations like this when it takes place, you wish you had better drainage, you know, because if they had better drainage, just maybe the water wouldn't be this high to have a car damn near fully submerged, you know, underwater. You know, look at these cars right here. They basically are submerged underwater right here. You see? And it has a lot to do with the drainage. You see? That one drain that they showed at the end of that video, it wasn't doing anything. It was fully backed up. You see? All because, well, tax dollars are not going where they are said to be going. If you know what I mean. So, it's always important to, you know, watch who you vote for. Ron DeSantis, you see what I'm saying? He's brung a lot of trouble on the community of South Florida there. As far as I'm concerned, with his little antics last year, talking all that he was talking against, issuing black travel advisories and stuff. Well, travel advisories for black people. You know, stuff like that. You understand? And then not taking the tax dollars, doing what he's supposed to be doing with them. that's just what it all boils down to. But that's just what it is, you know. We can get ready. The next video that I got coming up, well, it's just more, you know, proof that we're in the end times and we're about on the cusp of the Most High's arrival. I'm going to just say it like that. That's all I got on this one, people. I want you guys to tell me what you think about this particular story right here. I'm interested in hearing your thoughts on it in the comment section. Like, share, and subscribe. People, please remember to live your life as though we are being watched. Simply because we are. This is James, and I'm out. Peace.